JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for July the 30th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar continued to slide against all the other major currencies on Thursday and during the Asian session Friday. It fell the most versus NZD, CAD and CHF in that order. The weakening of the US dollar and the strengthening of the risk-linked Kiwi and Loonie suggests that markets continue trading in a risk-on fashion. That said, the strengthening of the Swiss franc points otherwise, thus in order to clear things up, with regards to the broader investor morale, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices were a sea of green, but today in Asia, all major indices tumbled, with Hong Kong's Hang Seng losing the most, Japan's Nikkei 225 losing the most ground. Yesterday, we noted that with Fed Chair Powell pouring cold water on quantitative easing tapering expectations, the dollar could stay under selling interest for a while more, while equities could keep drifting north. We were right about the dollar, and we still expect it to continue declining in the short run. But with regards to equities, we were correct only until yesterday's US session. Today in Asia, the picture was very different, and this may have been due to concerns over tight regulations in China resurfacing. It could also be end of month profit taking due to portfolio and risk exposure rebalancing, which could roll over into the EU and US sessions today. In any case, with the Fed disappointing those expecting hints over when it may start tapering its bond purchases, and the ECB adamant that it is too early to start withdrawing stimulus, EU and US equities may rebound at the beginning of next month and perhaps conquer fresh record highs. However, we cannot say the same about Asian indices, the technical pictures of which continue to suggest downtrends. Now, as for today, the main item on the agenda may be Eurozone's preliminary CPIs for July and the first estimate of the bloc's GDP for the second quarter. Eurozone's headline CPI is forecast to have ticked up to 2% year-over-year from 1.9%, while the HICP excluding energy and food rate is anticipated to have slid to 0.7% from 0.9% year-over-year. This comes in contrast with Germany's rates, which surged and even beat their estimates. The quarter-over-quarter GDP rate is forecast to have rebounded to 1.5% from minus 0.3%. However, if indeed the bloc's inflation numbers are as soft as expected, they will confirm the ECB's dovish stance last week. Remember that the bank changed its forward guidance, saying that it will keep interest rates at present or lower levels until it sees inflation reaching 2%, well ahead of the end of its projection horizon, which may also imply a period during which inflation moderately overshoots that objective. In our view, this translates into willingness to hold rates low for much longer than the previous guidance suggested, and may keep the euro underselling interest. However, Euro traders have already discounted to some extent the idea of the ECB staying sidelined, while dollar traders may have just started digesting, or let's say pricing in, Powell's remarks from Wednesday's press conference. With that in mind, we would expect euro-dollar to drift somewhat higher in the short run. We believe that the euro may continue losing ground against the kiwi, the central bank of which is expected to hit the hike button soon, perhaps as early as next month. Now, as for the rest of today's events, later in the day we get the US personal income and spending data for June alongside the core PCE index for the month. Personal income is expected to have declined again, but at a slower pace than the previous month, while spending is forecast to have slowed somewhat. The final University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for July is also due to be released, and it is just expected to confirm its preliminary estimate of 80.8. From Canada, we have the monthly GDP for May, with expectations pointing to a 0.3% month-over-month contraction, the same as in April. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.